What to Play presents 25 of the most anticipated PC titles coming out this year and beyond. With E3 coming to a close, we gave more priority to the games showcased during the event. To check out our complete list, check out our website at whattoplay.com. Link in the description box below. Battlefield 2042. The next generation of first-person shooters is coming this October 22nd. If you're expecting a story-driven adventure or a strong campaign, you might be disappointed since 2042 is strongly focused on multiplayer. Engage in insane, ever-changing battlefields and open-world firefights with players from around the world. Ride choppers and tanks and blow them up to smithereens in true new-gen visuals. Just look at that sandstorm, dude. Dying Light 2. The sequel to the impressive open-world zombie parkour game from the creators of the now-forgotten Dead Island series. Now with today's technology backing its gameplay, enjoy a living and breathing world full of undead. This time, it's leaning more into RPG territory. Make your own decisions and pick a faction from its splintered world. Hop from building to building during daytime, but be careful during the night. Coming out on December 7. Stalker 2, Heart of Chernobyl. One of Microsoft's most ambitious projects, a franchise that's more than 10 years old, Stalker's next chapter is gearing up for the next-gen experience. The world of Pripyat is as terrifying as ever, with crazy anomalies and mutated creatures. Looking at the trailer, the gunplay looks smooth, and the visuals and atmosphere are phenomenal. It's available to play on Game Pass once it comes out on April 28, 2022. Far Cry 6. Ubisoft's next first-person shooter slash open-world adventure is taking us to Yara, a fictional town ruled by a ruthless dictator played by none other than Giancarlo Esposito. Become a freedom fighter and save the oppressed people from Anton's bloody rule. As with all Far Cry games, you'll have a variety of weapons at your disposal. This time around, you're equipped with a backpack rocket launcher, and you can use animals to aid you in your missions to destabilize the government. Coming this October 7. New World. Amazon Studios' ambitious MMO project is nearing its release. New World is Amazon's attempt to make a bigger and better version of Blizzard's World of Warcraft. As a shipwrecked adventurer, make your own choices and survive the world using a variety of skills in real-time combat. There will be PvE and PvP challenges coming once the game is out this August 31st. Bleak Faith Forsaken. Anyone looking to scratch that Souls-like or Bloodborne itch on the PC can finally enjoy something similar with Bleak Faith. Set in a dark and desolate world full of eldritch terrors, play as a lone forsaken warrior wandering around its brutal open world. There's no definite release date yet, but it's scheduled to come out this year, if all things go well for the two devs working on it. Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Extraction. The Rainbow Team is facing a different threat this time around. Instead of themselves, the enemy is an ever-evolving parasite that can control a horde of dangerous creatures. If you've played Siege before, you'll be selecting from an array of familiar faces and working together in the three-player co-op. Think of it as a hostage mode, but with relentless enemies coming at you from every corner. Its $60 price tag might make it easy to snub your nose at. It comes out on September 16.
The Lord, I command thee.
Elden Ring. E3 started off strong by showing the much-awaited trailer for FromSoft's biggest game to date. Elden Ring feels like a combination of all things great about Dark Souls, Bloodborne, and Sekiro, packed into one impressive open-world RPG. The world is as immersive as ever, with its insane monsters and art direction. There's a lot of questions that still need to be answered, but at least we can finally say that the game is real.
For all of us.
It comes out on January 21, 2022. For Blood. It's time we say goodbye to the Left 4 Dead craze now that Valve has completely abandoned any hope for future content. The creators of that classic zombie shooter are currently pumping out a better multiplayer experience with Back 4 Blood. This zombie PvE can let you play with up to 3 friends and face off against hordes of dangerous undead, or engage in fun PvP where you play as the monsters. The beta was well received, so let's hope the full game goes up and beyond to prove that. It's coming this 12th of October and available on the Game Pass 4 days after.
Rocky, what are you doing?
Guardians of the Galaxy. A game that took us by surprise during Square Enix presentation. This brand new take on Marvel's ragtag group of heroes is somewhat refreshing. Follow Peter Quill and his gang as they embark on an interstellar adventure. Gameplay is similar to Marvel's Avengers, but with a strong focus on single-player story-driven gameplay, and only Quill as the playable character.
Guys, huddle up! Already missing the jiggle jelly!
There's still a lot of things that don't add up with the reveal, but we'll get some answers soon before it comes out this October 26. Atomic Heart. BioShock's estranged Russian sibling, well, not really. Monfish first-person shooter was in development for such a long time, but it looks like the wait is finally over. The trailers are still all about the Soviet BS. It comes with ray tracing support for those powered up GPUs, and it will be available on Game Pass at launch too. Avatar: Frontiers of Pandora. Ubisoft's final reveal during their presentation was something we didn't expect. We've known that there's more than one Avatar movie coming soon, but a video game? They didn't waste time showing us the gorgeous world it has to offer with a cinematic trailer. Unfortunately, no gameplay was shown, but knowing Ubisoft and their detail when it comes to their worlds, maybe we might be in for something more. It's coming sometime next year. Redfall. A new IP from Arkane Studios, the studio behind Prey and the Dishonored series. It was saved up for the very end of Bethesda's presentation. We expected more gameplay, but they only gave us a 5-minute cinematic detailing the adventures in a vampire-infested town. The characters look promising, and it's obvious that they have unique abilities that can aid players in co-op or solo. That's all we know so far, unfortunately, but it's expected to come out next year. Starfield, Bethesda's biggest project before we get to taste The Elder Scrolls 6. Starfield is the science fiction space exploration counterpart to their acclaimed medieval fantasy series. Although they gave no gameplay, a release date was shown, along with a glimpse into what we should expect in this brave interstellar frontier. It's a Microsoft exclusive that comes out November 11 next year, and it's available on Game Pass at launch. Tales of Arise. The latest addition to the Tales series is turning up the scale up to 11 with its fantastic visuals and massive worlds to explore. Arise will retain the tried and tested gameplay formula from its previous titles, but with the added flair of real-time engagements. The latest trailer revealed some of the characters we'll be playing. There's still a lot of mystery in its story, so maybe we'll hear more about it before it releases on September 10. Age of Empires 4. In development since 2017, we've been dying to know when this game will come out. Now with a firm release date and a strong publisher backing it up, Age of Empires 4 is finally a reality. From what we've seen in the trailer, it looks like the quality of its real-time strategy gameplay has improved. The visual overhaul makes every battle feel almost realistic. We can finally return to using our mouse and keyboards just like the good old days. It's coming out on October 28, and it will be available on Game Pass at launch.
You cannot hide from fate. But you can make your own.
Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. A spin-off to the acclaimed shooter from Gearbox, it still has the same amount of carnage and mayhem as we'd expect from a Borderlands game, but this time, more magic is involved. It's a full-fledged game with Borderlands bunkmaster Tiny Tina taking the helm. The game features co-op gameplay and the same snappy combat the series was known for. Expect some crazy new weapons here now that the fantasy genre is in the mix. It's slated for release this early 2022. Solar Ash. From the creators of the stylish Hyperlight Drifter comes a different kind of purple-soaked adventure set in a sprawling science fiction world. The recent trailer gave us a glimpse of its movement and combat, and yes, like Hyperlight, it's smooth and satisfying. Its fast-paced gameplay is a step up from its previous titles, now that it's on a third-person perspective. It's set to release sometime this year.
The demons have returned. With roaring destruction. Waking nightmares.
Lost Ark. Another competitor to the MMORPG market is a South Korean project that's bound for release this year. Like New World, it is completely free to play and is published by Amazon as well. The atmosphere and design are reminiscent of classic Final Fantasy worlds. It features a deep RPG system where players forge their own legend and mix and match adaptable skills. It's coming to the Western market this fall. Replaced. Pixel games have revolved around the indie realm for quite some time now. It's not expensive, and it gives more room for experimentation. In Replaced, this Microsoft-exclusive action side-scroller is oozing with style. The trailer gave off a combination of Blade Runner and Katana Zero with its action-packed gameplay and gorgeous futuristic visuals. Not much is known about its story yet, but we know it's coming to the Game Pass on day one next year.
Stick together and let's do this!
The Anacrusis. An infinitely playable four-player co-op where you survive a derelict spaceship surrounded by aliens. Yeah, it's not the most original plot, but it's compensated by its stellar writing, created by former Valve writer Chet Falajek. It's coming this fall 2021, and it's available on the Xbox Game Pass at launch. Forza Horizon 5. Microsoft's premier open-world racing game truly feels next-gen. 5 is the biggest and the most beautiful-looking Forza game to date. Set in the lush and arid Mexican landscapes, ride through the horizon with its seamless multiplayer gameplay where you meet other players around its massive world. The devs at Turn 10 Studios did a great job at replicating the atmosphere and photorealism of the landmarks of Mexico. It's coming out on November 9, and it's available on the Game Pass at launch. A Plague Tale: Requiem. The next chapter of Amicia and Hugo's journey might be its darkest yet. The rat-infested European streets are still around, and they're as dangerous as ever. However, what we've seen so far is only a cinematic trailer. The gameplay is limited, but we're sure to see more of it in the months to come before it comes out to Microsoft consoles and the Game Pass next year.
Alex!
It's just so good to see you again. Welcome to Haven.
This place is pretty sweet.
Life is Strange: True Colors. Deck Nine's latest Life is Strange project centers around a new character with her own supernatural ability. Alex Chen's empathic powers let her manipulate the world around her through feeling other people's emotions. It can make or break her journey to uncover the mystery of her dead brother. True Colors is the first of the series to release all episodes in one go. That means we don't have to wait for 3 months for an episode to drop. It's coming this September 10. Killing spree. Halo Infinite. Microsoft's much-awaited science fiction shooter is nearing its release. Somewhat. The recent Xbox presentation showcased its heavily demanded multiplayer mode, which launches alongside Master Chief's latest adventure as a free-to-play. The trailer gave us a few nostalgia trips, including old weapons and vehicles making a comeback. Not only that, the addition of the grappling hook mechanic gives players more room for mobility when taking out other players. Did we mention it's also coming out in Game Pass? Halo Infinite is coming out this fall.